on my device. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Good morning, Brittany. Good morning. So that today we just do a recap of you're not here yet. Stand by. There we go. All right, so we got a Brittany there. Can you hear me? Can you hear me, Brittany? Can you hear me? Oh, good. Lucky you. Aren't you lucky you can hear me? So I take it you're safe and sound and you're had a good Christmas. I just had a grandbaby a couple of days ago, so now I got five little girls and two little boys. Well, they're not so little now. So lots of grandbabies to take care of me when I get old. Well, older. It's kind of nice. Anyway, I hope you had a good Christmas too. So today we just review very quickly our consumer unit. All right, so review consumer or unit death. Because I get the sense that the week before we took off, before Christmas there wasn't a lot of activity happening. So if you've already done all this, that's fine, but I'll just review it. And then tomorrow we're going to start on some fun stuff, the transformations. Oh, you're going to love transformations. So here was the plan for today. Let's just review that. So here's pretty much what we talked about. You'll see this in my playlist and all my movies, of course. But there's what we were talking about. If you look at our class notes, and maybe you already saw this, so I'll make it kind of quick. All right, so the purpose of this is consumer decisions, Unit F. So when you buy stuff, what's the smart buy? So the first thing that I like to point out is when you go to the store, you know, they always say, oh, you can get 1 liter of milk for $1.62. And you can get 2 liters. Well, here's what, this is actually a picture from my store, right? So my Shoppers Drug Mart, there's what it says. And this was like a year ago. So you can get one liter, so 1 liter for $1.68, or you could get 2 liters, right? This is a 2 liter jug for $3.99. And sometimes it even says sale, right? Sometimes it'll say sale, buy me. You know what? How silly can you be? Why would you spend $3.99 to get 2 liters when it's actually way cheaper to get 1 liter for $1.68? All right, this is hilarious, but it's true. And let me just show you why. If 1 liter is $1.68, well, then another liter would be another $1.68, right? Another $1.68. And if you add up $1.68 and $1.68, it comes to, well, let me just tidy this up here so we can see what we're doing here. If you take $1.68 and $1.68 and add it up, that would cost you 2 liters. It'd be 8 and 8 is 16. Carry one. 6 and 6 is 12. Carry one is 13. Carry one. $3.36. All right. Helps if I know how to add. All right. So it'll be $3.36. So you could get 2 liters of milk, 2 1-liters for $3.36. Why the heck would you spend $3.99 for 2 liters? Right? Look, you get the exact same amount of milk. So by buying 2 ones instead of that single two, you actually, well, how much do you save? $3.99 for 2 liters, subtract $3.36. You actually save by buying the smaller cartons, two of the smaller cartons, that's three, that's another six. You save 63 cents. All right, so it's true. This happens all the time. It's not quite so bad at the grocery store like Loblaws and Safeway. But if you go to places, if you do your shopping at corner stores or Shoppers Drug Mart for your milk, they do this all the time. They'll suck you into buying this, and they'll usually put sale on there to fish you in even more. All right, so that's pretty nasty. All right, so I think you've seen all that. You would have seen all the movies. There's a picture of what it looks like when you go to Shoppers Drug Mart. All right, so it turns out that it's a heck of a lot smarter just to go and do some comparison shopping. So you want to do some comparison. You want to compare unit costs. So how much something costs for a unit, all right? So we'll try to make this quick because you've probably already done most of this, I would imagine. Okay, so obviously if you're gonna be figuring out how much money there is for a unit, you gotta know what different units there are. Sometimes you buy things by the meter, so when you buy boards and things. Sometimes you buy things by the milliliter when you buy liquids and fluids and cereal. Sometimes you buy things by weight, so you still got to remember your unit C stuff on how to convert stuff. All right, and you still got to remember how many pounds are in a kilogram in case you're comparing a bag of American apples measured in pounds with a bag of Canadian apples measured in kilograms. So you still got to know how to convert between the different units, and you were pretty good at that, Brittany. Okay, so let's just do a real quick thing in the notes. Obviously, if you're going to get a two kilogram bag of sugar for $2.69, you'd say, well, let's see, I want to calculate how much money there is per unit. And you go, well, a unit, a nice handy unit for us is a kilogram. Right, a kilogram is how much? Well, here's, if you filled this volume with sugar, that would weigh a kilogram. Okay, so a kilogram of sugar. So it turns out that if it's 2 kilograms for $2.69, you put the money in the top, so $2.69, and you put the lead and the units in the bottom, 2 kilograms. And if you do that, you'll find out that $2.69 divided by two is $1.35 per kilogram. So it's $1.35 for every 1 kilogram. And we don't bother writing for every 1 kilogram. We just say $1.35 per or for every 1 kilogram. And of course, if you do the same for the 4 kilogram bag, it's going to be $1.25 for 1 kilogram. So this is the better buy, of course. The bigger bag is usually, but not always, the better buy. So that's a better, and if you get the 10 kilogram bag, oh my goodness, that's like the weight of a 2-year-old, right? If you can carry that on the bus, even better, but you know, it's $1.10 a kilogram. So it turns out the best buy for money is the 10 kilogram bag. Well, what are you going to do with 10 kilograms of sugar? I don't think I would go through that in 10 years. All right. So unless you're a baker or something, you're probably not going to be buying the 10-kilogram bag. Chances are the 2-kilogram bag will last you for half a year. How about flour? All right, so a flour is $4.49 for every 2 kilograms. Right, so that's how much for 1 kilogram. So you just divide, $4.49 divided by 2. Can you do that in your head? That's $2.25, isn't it, when you round it? So $2.25 for 1 kilogram. Just go $4.49 divided by 2, and you come up with $2.25 and a half, which is $2.24 and a half, which is $2.25 when you round it. Whereas if you buy the 1 kilogram bag, oh, look at that, it's a little bit more. But then again, it'd be pretty easy to lug home on the bus. And the 10-kilogram bag is even cheaper, but of course,
yeah,
chances are you're not going to ever buy a bag that big. So you could say it's $10 for 10 kilograms, which really means if you divide 10 divided by 10, it's $1 for every 1 kilogram. So that's definitely the best buy, unless, of course, it sits in your cupboard and you have to throw it out because you sat there and got wet or something. So there's the idea behind unit cost. Let's just do the beans. Oh, you can do beans. Well, let's do the beans again. Notice this time we got sneaky. We had milliliters of beans, so 398 milliliters. Well, a Coke can is 355, isn't it? So this is just a single serving beans. And a 540, that's probably good for two of you if you throw some wieners or something in there. And 1.36 liters, well, that's quite a bit of beans. Right, there's 1 liter, so it'd be a little bit bigger than that amount of beans. So that'd probably serve two or three of you, maybe you and two kids or something. So let's calculate the unit cost, how much it is for a unit. Well, we got to decide what unit we're talking about. Are we going to measure things in dollars per liter? Or are we going to measure things in dollars per milliliter? All right, well, it turns out that, well, you know how much a milliliter is, eh? Would you believe that this is a milliliter? Yeah, that's a milliliter, by the way. And, yeah, it's pretty much the size of a bean. Are you going to go calculating how much it costs for one bean? Or are you going to calculate how much it costs for this amount of beans? Probably makes more sense. You can do it for every milliliter, but usually we do it for the liter. So let's calculate that. So, oh, by the way, this is where you got to know how to convert. It turns out that this one here is going to be $1.29. But if we're going to do it in liters, you've got to turn the milliliters into liters. So that's a 0.398 liters. And when you do all that with your plastic brain, let me find a plastic brain here. It's going to be what? $2.50. It's going to be about $3 a liter. All right, so let me do it there. $1.29 divided by 0.398. And let me check with my glasses because I'm old and I got to check this stuff. And we'll try to make this quick. Oh, see, good thing I took out my glasses. All right, turns out that's $3.24. So this here is going to be $3.24 for every 1 liter. So that's your $3.24 for this amount of beans. And of course, you can do the same with this one. So this is going to be $1.69. Usually the bigger size is the better buy, unless it's on sale or unless they're trying to trick you, which they do often. 0.54 liters, right? So we just went boom, boom, boom to turn it into liters. And if you do that on a plastic ring, 1.69 divided by 0.54, end up with $3.13. All right, so that's $3.13 for 1 liter. And then $1.36 liters for $3.39. So we put money in the top because we're always trying to calculate the amount per unit. $3.39, the units are dollars, and the liters are 1.36. So we don't have to convert that. So how much is that going to be per liter? Decimal 39 divided by 1.36 is $2.49. So $2.49 for this amount of beans. All right, so the first choice is $3.24 for this amount of beans. The second choice is, what did we say? That's right, $1.60. Oh, that's not right. $3.13 for this amount of beans. And the final choice was actually $3.39 for this amount. $2.49 for this amount of beans. All right, so here's what we were trying to calculate. We were trying to calculate, where did it go here? It was, 324 for 1 liter, or it was 3.13 for 1 liter, or it was 2.49 for 1 liter. So we're calculating how many dollars for 1 liter, how many dollars for 1 liter, how many dollars for 1 liter. All right, of course, you'd be a little neater than that. And here's another one here. Let's just do this. You'll see I've got movies on this. Let's do this one too. So, especially at Christmas time, they put stuff on sale. So let's say you're going to buy some Coke or soft drinks. So if you're going to buy 24 of the 355 milliliter cans, that's a normal can. Let's see, we want dollars per unit. And we've already kind of agreed that we probably want to measure how much you pay for a liter of stuff. You probably don't want to calculate that it's a tenth of a penny for that amount of stuff. That would be kind of silly, right? So you probably want to calculate it for a liter size. So let's see, 24 times 355 milliliters is the same as 24 times 355, 8,520 milliliters, which is, by the way, if you do all that fancy math, if you convert that, bing, 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 divide by 1,000, that's 8.52 liters, right? So if we do it in liters, 8.52 liters. So now we know we're spending $10.75 to get 8.52 liters. So that's how much to get 1 liter, right? So what do? You just pop that up to there. And so it's going to be 1 times that divided by that. So 1075, I'm not going to do all of these because I imagine you've already done them all, divided by 8.52. And you'll find out that's $1.26. So it turns out you're spending $1.26 for 1 liter of Coke. And you can do this one. I think this works out almost the same price. How about the 2 liter bottle of Coke? All right, that's easier to calculate. It's already in liters. So if it's 2.19 for 2 liters, then it's how many for 1 liter? All right, so you're just going to divide by 2. So that'll be $1.10. All right, so that's definitely the better unit cost. That's definitely the best price. However, don't forget, as soon as you crack the lid on that, it goes flat, right? So you might buy this, and then it might sit in the fridge for a couple of days and go flat, and then you throw it out. So did you really save any money? No. So sometimes you might end up having to buy something that's not the cheapest price. Let's grease through stuff. All right, gasoline. I don't know. Did you get a chance to do this one? Let's try this one. So this one's got a lot of conversions in it. So let's calculate the price per unit, and let's decide that it's dollars per unit. And let's calculate it in dollars for every 1 liter. Right? You could calculate it in dollars per quart or dollars per milligram or dollars for whatever you want. But normally we calculate things in dollars for this amount of stuff, because you can picture this amount of stuff. All right, so, hey, that's easy. How much does gas cost in Canada? It costs $1.20 for 1 liter. But careful now. Look at the units, dollars. A Canadian dollar is not the same as an American dollar. I hope you know that, eh? So you'd have to make sure people understood that it was $1.20 Canadian dollars for 1 liter. Now we're going to have to take that pesky American gasoline and convert that. All right, so how are we going to do that? Let's convert the American money first. Let's convert the money. So $4 U.S., like $4 U.S. And how do I convert that? It's just like converting dollars. It's just like converting feet to meters. We want to multiply it by some conversion thing. So we're going to put U.S. money in the bottom, Canadian money in the top. Notice how the U.S. money will disappear. We'll find out that it's Canadian money. And in the problem, I said, let's pretend that an American dollar is worth $1.05. All right, it's actually $1.30 Canadian to buy an American dollar these days. But sometimes it gets pretty good, $1.05. So it costs you $1.05 to buy 1 U.S. dollar. So it turns out that $4 American is the same as, well, you can do that, that's the same as $4.20. Canadian dollars. Don't forget to write down that it's Canadian dollars, because Canadian dollars is not the same as American dollars. Oh, now we got to convert the gallons. So don't forget the Americans have a gallon. A gallon's kind of like the size of a shoebox. It's kind of like four of these. Four of these makes a gallon. Kind of. Okay, so let's convert the gallons then. All right, so let's see. I'm going to convert them. I'll convert them here. So we got one U.S. gallon, and we want to convert that to liters. So we put liters in the top, gallons in the bottom. And you'd have to look it up or check out your tables from unit C, 3.785 liters. So there's 3.785 liters is the same as one U.S. gallon. Now we've converted the gallons into liters. All right, so it's 3.785 liters. And then all we got to do is say, well, how much money does it cost, dollars, for a liter? All right, so let's just calculate that. So if you're going shopping in America, you'd have to know how to do all this stuff. And what did I just do? What did I just do? Well, here we go. All right. So you're going to calculate that. So it's going to be $4.20 Canadian for 3.785 liters. And if you take that and convert it, let me do a separate slide. 420 for 3785. Let me fix that up. So if it cost you $4.20 Canadian, make sure you tell people what money you're using for 3.785 liters. Well, then how much is that in dollars Canadian for 1 liter? So 4.20 divided by 3.785, $1.10. Well, $1.11 if you round it properly. $1.11. All right, so it's $1.11 Canadian for 1 liter if you buy it in the States, whereas if you buy it in Canada, it's $1.20. So you don't really save that much money by buying your gasoline in the States. All right, so there we go. And then we had a couple of assignments. Maybe you did that F1 already. It was pretty much what we just did. Currency exchange. Let's do try to get that in this week. All right, so here was what F1 was all about. Calculate, you know, how much milk is and give a reason why. Give a reason why you might not buy the cheapest one. So F1 was tell me how much something costs per unit and give me a reason why you might not buy the economical choice. You know, maybe it's too big. Maybe it's not the brand you like. Maybe it's too heavy to carry on the bus. Maybe you don't have enough money on you to buy that size. Maybe you just end up throwing half of it out anyway, so you didn't really save any money. So give a reason why you might not buy the cheapest economical unit price. All right, lots of movies you can watch on this stuff. Converting currencies. All right, we're cooking. All right, so what's the time here now? I said I'd only be 30 minutes. Oh, I got to crank it up here. So converting currencies is exactly the same as converting meters to feet, or the same as converting kilograms to pounds, right? The only difference is you got to know whether you're coming or going, all right? So if you go to the bank, when you go to buy money from them, they'll charge you this rate. And when you go to sell money back to them, like if you're coming back from England or from America, then they give you a different rate. So it's exactly the same as converting feet to miles and kilograms to pounds, except that there's two different rates depending on whether you're coming or going. So whether you're buying or selling, the rates are slightly different. Let's do a couple of examples here. All right, say you want to buy some money. All right, so we'll probably go for 40 minutes here. Say you want to buy some money because you're going to go shopping in Fargo to get your teacher a birthday present. Okay, so you want to buy $120 American. So here, just let me blank this out. All right, so you want to buy $120 American, so you go to the bank and you ask the bank, but you tell the bank you want to buy some American money. And they say, sure, we'll sell you some American money. And they're going to sell you the money, so you've got to look on, you've got to look on the conversion rates, right? The conversion rates for, the conversion rates for American money. Oh, I had it printed out here. Where did it go? Stand by. I had it printed out. Oh, here it is. Okay. So I gave you a chart like this, and this is pretty much what it looks like when you go to the airport, or when you go to any bank, or any big hotel too will always exchange money for you too. So if you go to a fancy hotel or a bank or the airport, you'll see exactly this. I think, So according to this, in order to buy some American money, if you're going to buy, that means they are going to sell. All right, so you're buying, that means they are selling. So you want $120 US, and you want to convert that into Canadian dollars because you want to know how many Canadian dollars is the same as an American dollar. So since you are buying, it means they are selling, right? So they're going to sell you some dollars. So they will sell you some dollars because this is their chart. So they will sell you American dollars for $1.25. So $1.25 Canadian, right? All of these numbers here are Canadian dollars, it says right there. It says right there that this is Canadian dollar exchange rates. So you're going to spend $1.25 to buy an American dollar. And that's to get one US dollar. So, of course, we did the right conversion. So that means it's going to cost you 120 times 1 1/4. It's going to cost you exactly 150 Canadian dollars. There you go. So 150 Canadian dollars is the same as 120 American dollars. How about if you decide you want to go to Mexico? Right? If you want to go to Mexico and you decide, oh, I want some pesos. Well, let's do euros because they got euros on the chart here. All right, here's euros. All right, so you decide you're going to go to Mexico for the holidays. $1.5870. All right, so you want to buy some euros. All right, so you're going to go to where? You're going to go to France for the holidays. All right, so you go to the bank and you say, I want to buy some money, please. So here's the symbol they use, right? They use a funny looking E for a euro. And you say, I want to buy some euros because, you know, when you get off the plane in Paris, you got to have some money on you to pay for a taxi and, pay for different stuff. Maybe you want to grab a coffee while you're waiting for your luggage. So you need some money on you. So you decide you want to leave Canada with 650 euros. So you go to the bank and you say, hey, bank, I want to buy some euros. And they say, okay, well, here, look on this board. If you want to buy, we will sell you some euros. So it's going to cost you 1.5870 Canadian dollars to buy 1 euro. So we're almost done here. All right, so 1.587 euro Canadian. Right, make sure you're writing it. If you don't write down the units, you will be so lost for 1 euro. All right, notice how we converted euros into Canadian dollars. So if you want to have 650 euros so you can kick around in France, you'd have to grab your plastic brain here. It's going to be about $1,000. All right, 650 times 1.587. So you better give the bank $1,000, $1,031.55. So if you give the bank $1,031.55 Canadian, right? Lots of people have dollars. It's not just Canada, right? Australians have dollars. New Zealand has dollars. America, Jamaica, lots of countries have dollars. So whenever you use the dollar symbol, you got to tell people that it's Canadian dollars. Or American dollars, right? You can't just say dollars. Lots of people have dollars. All right, so if you decide you need 650 euros to pay for the taxi and, you know, the hotel when you arrive in Paris, you better give the bank $1,031.55. All right, so another couple of minutes here. Let's try you come home. And this is all in the notes, by the way. So let's say you get to the border with your 120 US dollars, and they say, excuse me, miss, but you're not into America because we're all locked down. So, oh, I forgot. So now you want to go back to the bank and you say to the bank, hey, give me back my $150. Well, they're going to laugh their heads off. They're not going to give you $150, are they? When you go back to the bank, they're going to only, if you're going to sell them the money back, they're going to buy it from you, but they're only going to pay $1.24. So they're going to cheat you out of a little bit of money, because the banks need to make money. All right, so let's try that one then. So you're going to convert the 120 US dollars into Canadian dollars. All right, so Canadian. And we're trying to get rid of US dollars. And one US dollar is, if you want to sell a US dollar, if you want to sell a US dollar, which means the bank is going to buy the US dollar, this is the bank's chart, the bank will buy the US dollar for 1.2360. All right, so it's a different rate, 1.236, which means you're only going to get back, well, let's multiply, 120 times 1.236 is 148.32. All right, that's Canadian, right? You got to make sure you write down that it's Canadian dollars. There you go. So that's funny, because you spent 150 to buy it, but when you cash it in, you only get 148.32. So you lost, what'd you lose there? You lost $1.68 in the deal, right? How about if you decide to buy some yen? All right, let's do some yen. 13,400 yen. So maybe you order, a video game from Japan, because they work in yen. Oh, it's not that simple. Here's the symbol for yen. It looks like that, right? So maybe you order a video game for your nephew from Japan, and on the bill it says 13,400 yen, but of course you're paying for it in Canadian dollars on your debit card or whatever. So you want to convert it. So you're trying to get rid of the yen, and you want to convert that into Canadian dollars. So now you got to look up, well, how many yen is the same as how many Canadian dollars? And I don't have it right there, so I'll look it up on my tables here. All right, so I'll look it up on my tables, and if I look for yen, and we're just about done here. Yen, Japanese yen, there it is right there. Japanese yen, there's their flag, Japanese yen. So we are going to buy some Japanese yen. So we are buying, which means the bank is selling, right? You got to pay attention to who's buying and selling. The bank will sell us the yen for, well, it's pretty much one penny almost, right? 0.01171. All right, so 0.1171, again, it's pretty much a penny, right? 0.01171 Canadian, right? Notice how it's pretty darn close to a penny for a yen. And that's for 1 yen. So $13,400 for your nephew's video game that you buy on Japan on the internet is 13,400, and then you're going to 13,400, and you're going to multiply that by 0.01171, and it ends up being $156. $156.91 Canadian dollars. All right, so that's how much your kid's video game would be. Nice. So that pretty much wraps up all that stuff, and then you've got an assignment for that as well. So that wraps that up. So that finishes unit F. Any good questions? Any questions at all? Questions? Okay, so if you're done there, let's read ahead. Read Unit G. Transformations. It's going to be kind of important stuff. All right, well, be good. Thanks for checking in. Bye-bye.